Testing wrist flexion against gravity. Patient will be in a seated position with the forearm resting on a table, palm towards the ceiling. We will be testing for two muscles, the flexor carpi radialis and the flexor carpi ulnaris. The first one that we will do will be the flexor carpi radialis. So the first thing you'll have your patient do is to perform full wrist flexion. So go ahead on all the way up and then back. Because he's able to do this, we know that he's at least a 3. To test for a 4 or 5, I will stabilize the forearm just proximal to the wrist, and then I will add resistance to the palm. But first, Owen, bring your wrist into halfway flexion. Okay, and then resist me. 3, 2, 1, 0. Depending on the resistance that he gives me, I will rate him as a 4 or 5. To test for the flexor carpi ulnaris, I will have him bring his wrist ulnarly and then into flexion. And then I will add resistance right here on the fifth metacarpal, going into radial, you know, pushing radially and into extension. Once again, stabilize on the wrist or proximal to the wrist. So resist me on 3, 2, 1. And once again, that is testing for the flexor carpi ulnaris. Testing wrist flexion, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a seated position, forearm lying on a table or flat surface with the hand in a neutral position. You'll have your patient perform wrist flexion in this position to the best of their ability. Very good, Owen, now go back. Because he was able to do any movement in this position, we would rate that as a 2. If he could not perform any movement, then I would palpate here on the flexor carpi radialis or the flexor carpi ulnaris, more so deep underneath. If I feel any of those muscles firing, that would be a 1, and if I do not feel them firing, that'd be a 0. Testing wrist extension against gravity position. Patient will be in a seated position with forearm resting on table, palm towards the table. To test for extension, wrist extension, there are 3 muscles that we're going to look at here. We're gonna look at the extensor carpi radialis longus, extensor carpi radialis brevis, and the extensor carpi ulnaris. So go ahead, bring your wrist into what the extensor carpi ulnaris would do for me, Owen. And now the longus, and now the brevis. So you wanna just stabilize the forearm and then have your patient bring their hand into each one of those positions, and then you add resistance. So go ahead, let's do the ulnaris first. So I'm going to apply resistance into radially and into flexion. So resist me, 3, 2, 1. Now do brevis, and I'm going to add resistance into flexion. So resist me, 3, 2, 1. And then for longus, I'm going to push it ulnarly and into flexion. So resist me, 3, 2, 1. Very good. Testing wrist extension, gravity eliminated position. Patient's forearm will be on a flat surface once again with the hand in neutral position. What you will have your patient do is perform wrist extension to the best of their ability. So go ahead and do that. Now, if there is any movement whatsoever, as he has shown here, that is at least a 2. If he cannot perform any movement while in this position, then I will come up here and I will palpate for the extensor carpi radialis longus, the extensor carpi radialis brevis, and the extensor carpi ulnaris. If I feel those muscles firing up here, that is a 1. If I do not feel them firing, that is a 0.